imagine he was working for a company. One of their clients was a very large Fortune 500 company, and they needed a very feature-rich and very complex web application built in Node. And by the way, for those who are unfamiliar with Node, JavaScript is most commonly used, or at least the traditional way is to use on the front end of a website, things like menus and things that are animated or things that you interact with. You know, fast content manipulation is often done on the front end, and your browser will parse JavaScript, right? So if you notice, if you ever turn off JavaScript in your browser, suddenly things like menus will stop working. You know, it's harder to interact with pages that use JavaScript. So Node, what that does is it does, it uses JavaScript on the server side. So a lot of processing and logic and manipulation happens before anything even gets to the browser. So that's what Node does. So the project that they were looking to do is build something in Node with all of these requirements, right? Some of the requirements was, okay, we need a CMS that can do this. We need a CMS that can do comments, conversioning. We need a, you know, and they were looking at all of these requirements. And at least at the time, they couldn't find a CMS that was natively available that did everything they wanted exactly the way they did. So, you know, they started looking at different ways they could do it and maybe combining things together. But ultimately, for this particular client, it came down to the user experience of the writing. And I'll share a quote that he said, "We were able to deliver a UI that elicited a round of applause from the content team. I love the work that's going into the Node.js ecosystem, but none of them can match 11 years of experience and an incredibly dedicated team who have made an incredible publishing UI." So, for those of you that are doing the math, he said this in 2014. So, yeah, and it's true, right? So, the answer to this question, the main answer, at least in my mind, to this question of why the heck would you ever use WordPress for any of these things, is WP admin, right? Because if you're using that as your application layer, you're going to have a great writing experience, right? And it already solves for all of these things, right? User management, custom content flow, and all of these other things. This is a quote by me. WP admin is perfect for any project because it can be changed for any project. And I'm not talking about reinventing the wheel. I'm talking about things that WordPress does really, really well, like white labeling and customization. So it's not just that it's great out of the box, which it is great out of the box. You can customize it and white label it in really kind of fun ways. And there's a lot of plugins that even if you don't understand how to use the code yourself, you can just install things like white label CMS. AG custom admin is another good one. And what these will do is you can customize things about WordPress, not just the colors and things, but the actual functionality, how things work a little bit. One, when I was building a site for my mom, which if you're watching, you were one of my toughest clients. So this little message down here at the bottom, thank you for creating with WordPress. Anyone with a WordPress site log in with WP admin, you can probably see this in whatever language the locale is set to in the bottom left. I changed this to be a little bit different. Got a question? Don't forget, you can always ask me for help. Right? I found that this prevented digging into settings that I didn't want changed. That was the easiest way to solve that problem. Right? But jokes aside, that's actually a really common thing when you're dealing with clients is to be able to not just like lock things down or prevent things from happening, to provide custom white labeling that will be useful, right? Like adding a content form inside a WP admin that says, hey, if you need help, you know, you can change this here. You can add custom workflows and editorial processes and all of these things in a kind of really rich ecosystem that exists in the WordPress.org repository and other places. Oh, by the way, bonus plug-in time. So this one here is called Admin Menu Manager. And I actually some taxonomies, but here in the editing system, I didn't really have to explain much. It was already very clear that, you know, when she was writing about, you know, our most recent trip to Utah, our most recent trip to Mexico, she could use posts, and that things like pages were in another section, but recipes were in one place, right? And the way you can organize information can be structured differently too, because one thing, if you're trying to use something that already exists, like Blogger, right, sometimes people will find, oh, well, I want to give credit to things. Should I just throw it in the body of the text? If it's a recipe, oftentimes the person publishing it is not necessarily the person who wrote it. Recipes are often collaborative, right? So you can organize that information with custom meta. So something like this, you can, you know, it's a very simple example, but I don't have to explain this UI at all. Right? It's perfectly understood that, oh, on the side those are recipes. There's a little carrot, right? You click on it, you can do the recipes. You can add new ones, you can, you know, change things around. So that is worth all of the other changes that need to happen so that this, you know, entire application layer has WordPress at the center of it. Because WP admin is kind of the, you know, answer to this question. Also, for those who have not heard of it, advanced custom fields is a quick, easy way for, you know, people like me to add fields and custom things to WP admin, right? And you can add new settings and new options. It's a really easy way to jump into that. So there's also other reasons like security and things. You might want to lock things down, or if you've got a really large multi-site and you want to cut the scope of that to something specific, right? There's reasons why that would make sense. But ultimately speaking, it's WP admin is the thing that we all know and love, and it is, in my mind, the answer to why WordPress, right? Because the editing experience is one of the best. And it's one of the reasons why, you know, the jokes that have been made today about how there's a lot of Gutenberg talks, changing the way that we edit this is a big deal, right? And changing the interaction at play to move us into something that can, you know, take us 10 years ahead, right? We've been using this same editor for about 10 years. We're gonna, you know, Gutenberg will make us, maybe take us 10 years further, right? It's a big deal, and we're very careful with it because this is, for many systems, the why of WordPress. So, getting back to the Internet of Things. The Internet of Things, as a quick, you know, introduction, is anytime something is, you know, connected to the internet and is a thing. So technically, a phone would be, but usually we're thinking of things like smart devices, things like badges that you can wear around, things like smart TVs or smart refrigerators, or devices that you just leave on in your home and you can interact with like that. So using WordPress as a, you know, application layer for some of those things allows for really quick and easy innovation in those places because there's already this ecosystem that makes it super easy. So if you want a really quick way to jump into this, I would suggest IFT. This is something that probably you could try right now on your laptop and have WordPress talking to a real device by the end of the talk. It's a very simple thing. It's just if-then statements. Hey, you know, if this, then that. So it's a really easy way to create things like, you know, an information radiator where you are a scoreboard or, you know, something like, oh, well, every time there's a post, trigger this action. A really kind of fun, interesting one that I saw was every time there was a new ticket created for a help desk, a light would turn on, and that light had to be manually, physically turned off. So, you know, it's one way to drive yourself crazy, but, you know, fulfill all your tickets. So this is a really easy thing that integrates with a ton of different things. And there's other third-party plugins you can use to extend the functionality further. But with this, it just uses your WordPress credentials and you're off. It's a really, really easy way to go. So for those that might be watching on WordPress.tv, look at the screen. I'm about to say that A word, so if anyone has a device that is about to be triggered, get ready for it. But Amazon Echo and Alexa Skills, no Alexa, stop listening. But Alexa still lot of these things are built in. The only thing that was missing was, oh, we need to render some JSON that returns information for given queries. Well, luckily we have that now baked into core, so extending the WordPress for API is really easy, and there's plugins that will let you do that. This next one is actually super fun if you want to play around with it. It's called Little Bits. For those that want to get into, if you've ever heard of like Arduinos or Raspberry Pis or some of those things, but you're like me and some of those things are scary, right? Because it requires like actual knowledge. So Little Bits is a good way to go. It was designed for kids, but I don't think about that part. What it lets you do is you can actually snap together just pieces of physical modules, and they'll do things. So like a really basic one would be if I've got like a little, you know, power module to a fan and like another module for a button, I can click it and the fan will turn on. Or if, you know, a buzzer module, or if then. Well, there's one of their modules that's kind of cool that is, and you know, the different pieces like processors and things just snap together so you don't have to weld anything or solder anything. But yeah, they've actually got something they call a cloud module, which will interact with their API and, you know, do a lot of the hard parts. But there's a plugin that will interact with their API and use the REST API to do things like, you press a button and suddenly WordPress is connected. So you can do some really, really cool things. You can hook it into just about any action filter in WordPress. So this would actually be, if you were looking to set up something like, oh, I want a physical light to turn on when I've got a new store order, right? And I just, you know, I want this cool thing that blinks at me every time I've got an order, and if it's blinking a lot, I feel good, right? Something like that. This would actually be a really, really easy way to do that, and a really cheap way to do that. And the one thing that's kind of fun about Little Bits is even if you do have the knowledge to put together like a real piece of hardware, this is a really good way to prototype. Because you can just snap stuff together, and if it doesn't work out, well, you can snap it together in a different way and try something else. So it's almost like staging for hardware. Which is really fun. But yeah, this would be a really good thing to try out if you just want to jump into it quickly. Another kind of funny one that I found, maybe not the pinnacle of human achievement, but I thought it was really cool, are Slack bots. So one in particular is, for those of you who've used Slack before, you can create custom integrations. And this one was called Hey Kramer. They use the JSON API to actually create endpoints where the whatever you were posting or whatever you were getting would get, you know, thrown over to WordPress, and WordPress would return something that was understood by Slack, right? And you could throw in GIFs and things like that. So, hey, give me a Kramer quote. I'm telling you, the big man is alive. The government's been experimenting with big men since the 50s. You can do that, and WordPress actually spat that back using the REST API. It's pretty cool, right? And so you've got, you know, you can use WP Admin and Wilbur, you know, any of the apps that integrate with WP Admin, and really easily and quickly have this editing experience where you can do things like this. Or, hey, give me a Kramer GIF, right? And it returns one. So that's kind of a fun thing that exists, and there's a million other things that exist. But ultimately, with WordPress and the power of what you can do, if you think of all of the different reasons why you'd want to use WordPress and all of the different plugins that exist, what the REST API does is it brings that to an entirely different level where WordPress can be your application layer in the center of all of these things, and you can have everything from iOS apps, custom Alexa skills, everything in the middle can be interacted with in WordPress. Kind of one of the, you know, core feature or the core purpose that was declared in the WordPress Foundation was to democratize publishing, right? And so by making things like, oh, well, now anyone can share their stories, now anyone can share this information, it's actually accomplishing that in ways that we probably wouldn't have thought would exist 10 years ago. So it's a really powerful thing. And you know, the internet